testing, and it seems like forever ago that they were dropping bombs into Mexico. It's recently, my son told me that his best friend, who's 49, has bladder cancer. This is the son of one of those army people they put into the desert to see what the effects of radiation were. His father died of cancer when he was 10. Dave now has bladder cancer. He has a son who's 10, and he is facing death from that dropping of the nuclear weapons in New Mexico. So though it feels like a century ago, half a century actually, it's very, very clear to me that we're still experiencing right here in this country as I watch my son's best friend struggle with cancer. The other thing I wanted to share with you is something Dan Berrigan said during the trial of the Catonsville Nine. And he said, the waging of peace is as costly as the waging of war. The problem is we peacemakers are unwilling to pay that cost. And as we face the next 3.5 years of this president, we're going to have to pay more and more cost to stop the insanity that he is bringing on us. And each time we stand up and take a risk of getting arrested, small risk, but we don't know what the future is going to hold for us under Trump. So we have to continue taking those steps, because courage only comes not on the first step, probably not on the second, maybe on the third. So I'm really grateful to be here with all of you. We have to stop these weapons now.
I'm going to cheat, and because I found the sheet I was looking for, Archbishop Hunthausen in 1981 said, nuclear arms protect privilege and exploitation. Giving them up would mean having to give up economic power over other people. Peace and justice go together. On the path we now follow, our economic policies towards other countries require nuclear weapons. Giving up the weapons would mean giving up more than our means of global terror. It would mean giving up the reason for such terror, our privileged place in the world. Archbishop Hunthausen, July 12th, 1981. Okay, somebody else come.